got an empty.
Hi everybody, so fantastic to see you all. Wasn't that an amazing march? Amazing! Thank you all so much for coming. There must have been thousands there. McDonald's Club's anything to go by. There's a million of us! There's millions! Can I just say thank you all as well to my fantastic CLP from Bally and Spen. Scrubs and the unions that have turned up is fantastic turnout, thank you so much. But can I just tell you, when we were coming down this road just now, there was a lady sadly on the side of the road having a fit, and my friend Jude, who's a nurse, the first thing she did is she put down her banner and she ran across the road to see what she could do. And we saw that last week in that awful incident in Westminster when I was locked in the chamber. We saw our colleagues going from St Thomas's running towards danger. They are heroes and we need to celebrate them. And you don't celebrate heroes by giving them a 1% pay rise. We've heard all about that, but we also have been hearing from Simon Stevens, haven't we? His 5-year forward plan. Well, I don't know about you, but there was not one mention of money. Not one mention of where this money's going to come from. And just so I can talk you through it, he said, waiting times are going to be increased. What does that mean? Older people waiting for a hip operation are going to be more isolated, more in pain, more outside of our community. He said, GPs are cutting referrals, which means rationing by the back door. And he said, certain products will not be available on the NHS. Well, while we accept that paracetamol is probably cheaper getting it from Boots than on prescription, there are people like celiacs who, when you're poor, you cannot afford to go to Tesco's and pay over the odds for a slice of bread that's going to keep you well. It is rationing by the back door, and we will not accept it. And it's not just me that thinks that. Dr. Mark Porter from the BMA, the British Medical Association, he says, delivering a promise only by missing another is textbook rationing. This isn't the First World War, the Second World War. We are not going to accept rationing in our NHS. Yay! And we've heard, haven't we, from Theresa May that there's going to be parity of care for people with mental health issues. She walks the walk, but does she talk the talk? No, she does not. And why? Because the 800 million that was put on one side for mental health, where did it go? It was diverted to balance the books in the NHS. They say one thing and they do another. And let me tell you, I've been in a room with Jeremy Hunt and he is slick. He is Mr. Slick. And I've been campaigning for the last 6 months when I've been an MP for Batley and Spen against the downgrade of Dewsbury Hospital. I've campaigned, I've sent questions in to the Prime Minister. I've campaigned and fought against Jeremy Hunt, and he just says it's actually a local problem. It's a local issue. It's not, it's a national issue. And also what are we going to say to all those European Union workers? 55,000 EU workers in the NHS. 80,000 who work in social care. What are we going to say to them? Go, no, we're not going to use them as bargaining chips. They are welcome, they are colleagues, yay, they are valued, yay, they are the heart of our NHS. Yay. And just to finish, because you've heard loads of speeches and I know you want to get down to Nando's, we are the Labour movement. We stand together for workers and we stand for our National Health Service. Nye Bevan said, the NHS will last as long as their folk with faith to fight for it. While we have faith, we will continue the fight because we built the NHS. Yes. We invested in the NHS.